Now let us solve one problem using visual brain method. See, here is the first problem. A rectangular pyramid of base 30 mm by 20 mm and altitude 40 mm is kept with its base on the ground with the 30 mm edge parallel to the picture plane and 5 mm behind the picture plane. The station point is 30 mm in front of the picture plane, 40 mm towards left of the axis and 45 mm above the ground. Draw the perspective view. So the question is given, object is a rectangular pyramid with a base 30 by 20 and 30 mm side is parallel to the picture plane and it is 5 mm behind the picture plane. So details of the object is given and the height of the object is 40 mm. So it is a rectangular pyramid, which means the top view of the pyramid will appear like a rectangle and the diagonals are visible. Front view is a triangle with a dimension 30 by 40 because 30 mm edge is parallel to the picture plane. And the position of station point is also given. It is 30 mm in front of the picture plane and 40 mm towards left of the axis. That is, central plane is 40 mm towards left of the axis of the object and 45 mm above the ground plane. You know the steps. Let's see the steps one more time. First, you have to draw the picture plane, plan of picture plane, PPP line. Then draw the top view of the object. Third step, draw the elevation of ground plane, EGP line. Then draw the front view of the object. Fifth step, draw the station point in top view, small letter s, mark station point in front view, s dash. Then draw EHP line, draw visual rays in top view, draw visual rays in front view, mark the intersection points in PPP line, then mark the points in the visual rays in front view, join the points, you will get the perspective. Let's follow these steps to get the final perspective of this question. Okay, let's move to the first question, first step. That is, draw the picture plane, plan of the picture plane, PPP line. It is a horizontal line. So I'm starting with this point. Draw a horizontal line like this. And its name is PPP line. So that is the first step. Draw a horizontal line like this. You can place it here, almost at the center or just below the center of the paper. So that is a horizontal line. Its name is PPP line. It is actually representing the picture plane. Now you can draw the second step, that is, draw the top view of the object. Where is the object? Object is 5 mm behind the picture plane. So the plan of the object or top view of the object is 5 mm behind the picture plane. So you have to take 5 mm from this picture plane, then you can draw the plan of the object. Object is a rectangular pyramid, so top view will appear like a rectangle. And we have to mark the position of the object and the observer here. So you have to fix the position of the object and observer before doing this problem itself. See, it is given that observer is 45 mm towards left of the axis of the object, which means you have to draw the object on the right side and observer on the left side. So I am going to draw the top view of the object here on the right side. See, you can draw the plan of the object like this. The plan is 5 mm below or behind the picture plane. So you can take 5 mm from the picture plane, then draw a rectangle with the dimension 30 mm by 20 mm. The 30 mm side, this side, is parallel to the picture plane because it is given in the question. Since it is a pyramid, the diagonals are visible in the top view, so you can draw lines like this, lines from the corner points. So these lines are also visible. So this is the top view of the object. Now you can draw the third step. Draw the EGP line, elevation of the ground plane. Elevation of the ground plane. Ground plane will also look like a horizontal line in front view. So front view is also known as elevation. So elevation of the ground plane is a horizontal line. So this step means you have to draw a horizontal line. Draw the elevation of ground plane means you have to draw a horizontal line. But we don't know the position of the ground plane. So you can assume that distance. You can take just 15 mm or 20 mm from this top edge of the plan of the object, then you can draw a line. So that is an assumption. Here I am taking 15 mm from this top edge of the object, then I am drawing a horizontal line. Its name is EGP, elevation of the ground plane. You don't have to represent the dimension value here because that is an assumption. So you can take 15 mm, 20 mm. It is convenient, it is according to your convenience. If you have enough space, you can draw a line 20 or 25 mm from the object, no problem. So just draw a horizontal line, that is elevation of the ground plane, and on this line we are placing the object because the object is resting on the ground plane. So we need a ground plane to draw the front view of the objects. Now you got the top view, you can draw the projection lines to get the front view. And to get the height, you have to draw a projection line from this center point, then project it, you will get the axis height. As we know, we have 5 points here in the top view, and from all the 5 points you can draw the projection lines. And I'm drawing the projection line from the axis. So what is the height of the object? That is 40 mm, altitude is 40 mm. Take 40 mm, so you'll get the center. Similarly, you can draw projection lines from the end points. You'll get the end points here in this EGP line. So now you can draw the front view of the object. Front view is a triangle. Front view is a triangle like this. Okay, now you have to mark all the 5 points here in this triangle. This point is O dash, this is A dash in bracket E dash, this one is B dash in bracket C dash. So we completed the object, but front view of the object is here, top view of the object is here. Once again, I am explaining the steps. First, draw the PPP line, then draw the plan of the object, top view of the object, and take 15 or 20 mm from the object. You will get EGP line, it's a horizontal line, elevation of ground plane. And on the ground plane, the object is resting, then you can draw the front view of the object. After that, you have to mark the central plane. Central plane is actually passing through the eye level of the object, and it is given that the station point or the eye level or observer is 40 mm towards left of the axis of the object. So from the axis you have to take 40 mm. So from the axis I am taking 40 mm. Take 40 mm, then you will get the central plane like this. Draw the central plane. You can mark this distance here. The distance between axis and central plane is 40 mm. Now you have to mark the station point in front view and the top view. Station point in top view. It is given that station point is 30 mm in front of the picture plane. Something is in front of the picture plane means it is below that line. So it is below PPP line. In front of the picture plane means in front of the PPP line. So from this point I am taking 30 mm. So this point is small letter S. This point is small letter S. The position of station point in top view. Similarly, it is given that it is 45 mm above the ground. So from the ground you have to take 45 mm. So you will get the position of station point in front view. So that point is actually representing the station point in front view. Take 45 mm, you will get the S dash. So you have to represent the front view, that is S dash, and top view S of the station point. Next step, draw the EGP line, draw the EHP line. EHP line means elevation of horizon plane. Horizon plane is a horizontal plane parallel to the ground plane. So you will get a line parallel to the EGP line because both are horizontal planes, and the horizontal planes will look like horizontal lines in front view. And since the horizon plane is passing through the eye level of the observer, so you can draw a line passing through S dash, horizontal line passing through S dash. So that line is known as EHP line. In this question there is no relevance for this particular line, but in some other questions we need to draw this line because that is important in that problem. Anyway, I am just drawing that line, that is known as EHP lines. All these lines are construction lines, EHP, EGP, PPP line, and plan and the elevation of the object, they are also construction lines. You have to use very light lines because your answer is the 3D picture, that is known as perspective, and that is the 12th step. In the 12th step only you will get the perspective. So all other lines are very light lines. Now you can move to the next step, that is you have to draw the visual rays in both the front view and the top view. Those are lines connecting point S with all points in top view and point S dash with all points in front view. So let's see how the visual rays will look like. So I am drawing lines connecting S and A. Similarly, line from S and S to B, then S to C, then S to D. See, these are the visual rays in top view. Similarly, you can draw visual rays in front view. S to O dash, S to A dash and D dash. There are two lines, but they are overlapping each other, so you can see only one line. S to B dash and C dash. You have to draw one more line in top view, that is S and O. So total 5 visual rays in top view and 5 visual rays in front view. Now you have to draw projection lines from the intersection points of visual rays with the PPP lines. If you see the top view, in top view these visual lines are rays are intersecting with the picture plane PPP at somewhere. So this is the visual ray connecting A and S. I am drawing a perpendicular projection line from A to the visual ray in front view, S dash A dash. So draw lines connecting intersection point of visual ray with the PPP line. So we have to draw the projection line like this, perpendicular projection line. So you will get one point here in the visual ray in front of you, S dash A dash line. On S dash A dash line, we will get an intersection point. The projection line from PPP line is meeting somewhere on the S dash A dash line. And that point is, that is capital A dash or capital A. Similarly, if you draw projection line from point B, you will get a capital B here between S dash B dash line. Project the intersection point of visual ray SC. See, SC line is intersecting somewhere on PPP line. From there, we are drawing a projection line to S dash C dash line. You will get a capital C. Similarly, draw a line connecting S and D. You will get an intersection point on PPP line. From there, we are drawing a projection line. You will get a capital D like this. You have to mark point O in S dash O dash line in the same way. Now you got total 5 points. They are represented as capital letters because in 3D you are representing lines using or points using capital letters. Now I am going to draw lines connecting these points. First you have to draw the outer boundary. They are continuous. You can draw continuous lines connecting the outer boundary. Let's see how to draw the final perspective. To draw the final perspective, we have to draw lines connecting these points. So these are the outer boundaries. Point C is actually inside. If you are looking from, see, if an observer is watching an object from this side, he can see this triangular face and this triangular face. But point C is not visible, which means we have to draw dotted lines. So draw dotted lines connecting point C and D, D and O, and B and C. See, this blue color picture is actually known as the perspective of the square pyramid. You have to draw a line connecting A and O because that line is also visible. So we have a square pyramid, sorry, rectangular pyramid. If it is a rectangular pyramid, it has a 5 corner points and a total 8 edges, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 sliding edges and 4 edges on the base. So all edges are visible here. So this is the 3D or real-time view of the square pyramid. See the change. So this is a 3D object. This is how the object will, you know, look when we watch the object at a height of 45 mm above the ground level, and if the observer is 40 mm towards the left and he is standing 30 mm in front of the picture plane. So how do you understand the steps? Just follow the steps to get the similar solutions or for solving this kind of problems. For all perspective problems, we are using this method, visual ray method. There are some other methods, but we are using visual ray method to solve the problems.